To the top of the countdown, and in our number one story, we have seen the intersection of overblown, misguided media analysis and the body language of Michelle Obama time and time again. As evidence, that fist bump shared between husband and wife after Barack Obama locked up the Democratic nomination, which prompted this little cherry from Fox News.
A fist bump, a pound, a terrorist fist jab, the gesture everyone seems to interpret differently.
This time, it's not Fox News' terrorist fist jab, but a royal back hug that has the media in a tizzy. Yesterday, during a reception at Buckingham Palace, the Queen of England and America's First Lady shocked the royal watching world when they were spotted with their arms around each other's back. Apparently a gross breach of royal protocol. The headline from the Daily Mail, "Did Michelle Obama break royal protocol by giving the Queen a hug?" The Times of London. Protocol is abandoned as Michelle Obama cozies up to Queen. Unfortunately, in the video, even with this countdown forensic enhancement, you can't tell who caressed who first. Luckily, an eyewitness clarifies the situation to the Daily Mail. The Queen appeared to look up at her and make a comment about how tall the First Lady was. As she did, she put her arm around Mrs. Obama and rested her gloved hand on the small of her back. Almost simultaneously, Mrs. Obama put her arm around the Queen's shoulders rather more firmly. That revelation seemed to let a little air out of any Michelle Obama screwed up balloon. Earlier this afternoon, our own royal commentator Dickie Arbiter contextualized the caress.
Who cares? If she didn't want to do it, she wouldn't have done it. Who cares?
Buckingham Palace agrees with Mr. Arbiter's spokesman today, saying the embrace was a, quote, mutual and spontaneous display of affection, and we don't issue instructions on not touching the Queen. Today, the displays of affection, spontaneous and otherwise, continued for Mrs. Obama during a visit to a multi-ethnic girls' school from London. Here's Donna Friesen.
She has dazzled Britain with her style and her substance. From the palace to the streets, she has taken London town.
This is just a small example of the First Lady's ability to draw a crowd. Word spread that she was coming to a school near here, and these people have been waiting for hours.
First Lady of the United States of America, this is Michelle Obama.
Erupting with shrieks of joy, the teenagers at this London girls' school were completely surprised by the visit. The students, 90% of whom are from ethnic minorities, sang their hearts out for her. It clearly struck a chord.
All of you are jewels. You are precious, and you touch my heart. And it is important for the world to know that there are wonderful girls like you all over the world.
It was a speech from the heart, Mrs. Obama telling them they could all be just like her.
We need strong, smart, confident young women to stand up and take the reins. I want you to know that we have very much in common. For nothing in my life's path would have predicted that I'd be standing here as the first African-American First Lady of the United States of America. I wasn't raised with wealth or resources or any social standing to speak of.
To such a diversity of girls from such an inspirational woman, the message couldn't have been more powerful.
You too can control your own destiny. Please remember that. You know, if you want to know the reason why I'm standing here, it's because of education.
She also talked about men.
The men in my life taught me some important things as well. They taught me about what a respectful relationship should look like between men and women. They taught me about what a strong marriage feels like.
When it was over, the hugs began, and it seemed they'd never stop. Mrs. Obama even moving to the audience, ignoring Secret Service agents who tried to steer her away. As they left,
Michelle Obama hugged me. Oh, wait, let me.
The girls could hardly contain themselves.
Is it important to have women like her as role models?
Yes. Yes.
Why is that, do you think?
Because then, like, it can encourage other children to be like her and to push and not to just, like, laze around and give up.
Some thrilled to tears, all a result of what seems to be Mrs. Obama's powerful personal magic. Donna Friesen, NBC News, London.